Welcome to the Curious Giraffe Show for curious kids of all ages, where there's always a song and no question is wrong. And we'll start with our theme song. Here we go. Giraffe looked over an eagle and said, "Why was I born to walk? Why were you born to fly?" Eagle just shrugged and gave a high five. Hey, we all share one big sky. Oh, yeah. Share one big sky. Share one big sky. Give the world a big high five. Yeah, we're different and we know it, but we all get along. We can all share and we can all care. We're different, but we all belong. Giraffe looked over at zebra and said, "Why do I have spots? Why do you have stripes?" Zebra just shrugged and said, "We come in all types, but we all share one big sky." Oh, yeah. Share one big sky, share one big sky. Give the world a big high five. Yeah, we're different and we know it, but we all get along. Cause we can all share and we can all care. We're different, but we all belong. Giraffe looked over at jaguar and said, "Why am I so tall? Why are you so fast?" Jaguar just shrugged and said, "It's all a blast, but we all share one big sky." Oh yeah. Share one big sky, share one big sky. Give the world a big high five. Yeah, we're different and we know it, but we all get along. Cause we can all share and we can all care. We're different, but we all belong. Giraffe looked over at rabbit and said, "Why is your family big? Why is my family small?" Rabbit shrugged, "As long as there's a place for us all, and we all share one big sky." Oh yeah. Share one big sky, share one big sky. Give the world a big high five. Yeah, we're different and we know it, but we all get along. Cause we can all share and we can all care. We're different, but we all belong.
So we did have that new verse again. Not quite. We had that new verse again. What do you think this new topic will be today? What is Giraffe asking about?
About family.
Maya.
About families?
Yes, about families. And
we had that last time.
We had homes last time, which is very closely related to families. Good remembering.
No, we had it, last time, not like 2 weeks, not two recordings ago.
But good remembering. The last show time, or one of our show times, we had homes, which is very related to families. But we're going to start today with our own families. And I want you, okay, you can turn it now to the new song. And as you hear the different verses, if you notice something about your family in the verse, you can put your hand up and say, "Yeah, that's true for my family." Put your hand down, listen again. "That's true about my family." "Oh, that's not true." Okay? So you don't have to sing the verses unless you want to, but I'll be singing lots of different things about families. But I also would like to teach the sign language for this song. So the sign language for family is the sign for the letter F. You bring it together, and then you bring the people together. So that's the sign for family. Take time. You touch where some people wear a watch. Take time to see. Put your fingers just below your eyes and stretch them out like you're seeing. And then the fact about, no, that families are different. Different. You cross two pointer fingers and pull them apart. Different. And then love, you cross your heart, is the key. You hold one hand like it's the door. You take the other hand and make a key and turn it. Love is the key. Yes, it's love that makes a family. Okay, so try that with me. Here we go. And remember to listen to the verses and notice what's true about your family. Okay, it goes like this. There are all kinds of families when we take time to see. When we look at our family, they're as different as can be. But the fact about a family is that love is the key. Yes, it's love that makes a family. Some families have a mom or dad, a boy. Anybody have a mom or dad? I'm like, oh, good, okay. A boy or a girl. Some of us have folks who came from all around the world. And some families have two moms or dads, and maybe boys or girls. Oh, it's love that makes a family. Everybody, I'll try it. There are all kinds of families when we take time to see. When we look at our families, they're as different as can be. But the fact about a family is that love is the key. Yes, it's love that makes a family. Some families have lots of pets and some families have none. Oh, let's wait a minute. How many have lots of pets? Anybody?
We have a dog.
How about anybody have no pets? Oh, not in this group. Okay. Some of us have none, but all of us have chores to do. Anybody help out at home? But when the chores are done, there are special days and special ways our families have fun. Oh, it's love that makes a family. There are all kinds of families when we take time to see. When we look at our families, they're as different as can be. But the fact about a family is that love is the key. Yes, it's love that makes a family. Some families stay together, families that have always been together. And some families change minded. And they live in separate houses, but the love remains. Whether mommy or your daddy or grandparents tuck you in, oh, it's love that makes a family. There are all kinds of families when we take time to see. When we look at our families, they're as different as can be. But the fact about a family is that love is the key. Yes, it's love that makes a family. Some families use one last name and some families use two. Some are easy to spell and some are hard to do. But each and every family has folks like me and you. Oh, it's love that makes a family. I'll do it with you. There are all kinds of families when we take time to see. When we look at our families, they're as different as can be. But the fact about a family is that love is the key. Yes, it's love that makes a family. Some families come through marriage, and many through birth, and many through adoptions all over the earth. But whatever way they come to be, our families have great worth, for it's love that makes a family. Last time, everybody. There are all kinds of families when we take time to see. When we look at our families, they're as different as can be. But the fact about a family is that love is the key. Yes, it's love that makes a family. Thank you. So that's a new song for us. And about a topic you think you know a lot about. But we're going to use our little house, like you remember our show about homes and houses, and to talk about our family. So would you take that one, the first opener and open that up and tell us what question we're going to think about.
What or who is a family?
Okay, read it slower, one more time.
What or who is a family?
Who would like to try to answer that? What or who is a family? Okay, go ahead, Max.
It's a group of people that love each other.
A group of people who love each other. Nice definition. Everybody like that definition, or anybody want to say anything else? Okay. Oh, yes.
Also, a family could be related to each other.
They can be related.
Like the children are related to the mom and dad, uncles, cousins, grandparents, great-grandparents.
Definitely. All right. Excellent. Now, the others don't have a number. You'll each get a turn. Lila can go next. She's ready.
I don't know how to read.
Yeah, so pass it to someone next to you once you open it. I'm sorry. I rolled them tightly to fit in the house, but they're hard to unroll. You got it?
What does your family do at bedtime?
What does your family do at bedtime? Here, I'll take it. You want me to? Okay, anybody, tell us about how your family, what they do at bedtime. Xavier.
They just say time to go to bed. We do prayers and then we go to bed.
Okay, and remember, say that again slower, but so we all can hear you.
So we get ready for bed, and then they take us upstairs, we do prayers, and then we go to bed.
Okay. How about your house?
Well, we get ready for bed, then we go upstairs, and I tell my sister a story, read her story, and then we go to sleep.
Great. So your sister that you tell a story to, is she older or younger?
Younger.
Younger. She's lucky you're there to... Yes, Lila.
My parents put me to bed.
Your parents put you to bed. Do they read you a story or just tuck you in? That's nice. Okay, remember to speak up so our friends can hear us. Okay, you ready to take a question?
I'll take this one.
All right, try that. But here, you know what?
No, I can take it out.
Okay.
This paper is killing me. Who do you want to be with when you're happy or excited? Your family.
Yeah, but who in your family? Who do you enjoy sharing when you're happy and excited?
My brother, and my sister, and my mom, and my dad, and my big brother.
Great.
See, my entire family.
Okay, that's true for you. Yes, Lila?
My grandma.
And your grandma, grandparents. That's a fun answer, too. That's...
My whole family, including my pet parrot.
And your pet parrot.
You have a pet parrot?
Cool. See, we learned something new about each other.
It's a real parrot.
All right.
Pet parrot.
Who do you want to be with when you're sad or mad or worried?
Sad or mad or worried. Who in your family would you be with when you're feeling that way? Maya?
I like to be with my sister because she makes me happy usually.
Wow, isn't that nice? Your younger sister makes you happy, so she can help you with those feelings. Anybody else? Yes, Monet.
I like to be with my mom or my brothers, and sometimes my dad.
Yeah, that's great.
I like to be with my mom and also my siblings, which is my big brother, my brother, and my sister.
Yeah.
Depending on the case.
Right.
If my sister's mad at me, then I'm talking to my brother.
That's true.
Which is something that we need to talk about too.
My mom.
And your mom helps you. And Max made a point that sometimes you can be mad or sad with someone in the family, so you look for someone else in the family. So that's a good point. You didn't get a turn.
Yeah.
You can choose. Okay. Yes, she can.
Do you help sometimes? How?
Do you help sometimes in your family? Okay, keep thinking. You'll each get a turn. Monet.
In our family, we have to pull our own weight, which means do cooking, chores mostly.
And they call that pulling your own weight, helping out. So mostly cooking?
Mostly cooking and doing like chores around the house because my parents both work days and stuff, so it's really hard.
Wow. So a family helps out. Both your parents are working, so you all help. Mm-hmm. Yes.
So we're doing chores like washing the dishes or maybe clean the basement or something.
Yeah.
Not a lot of families have their kids do chores, actually.
You don't think so?
No, I know so.
Oh.
A lot of kids aren't. I know a few kids. My sister knows a few kids. I think I know one kid who does her chores, though.
Some kids aren't even grounded for what
some kids aren't.
When I was growing up, we almost all helped, and I'm very happy to hear that your family can count on you. Maya.
Well, sometimes if somebody's sick in my family, I have to take care of them. Like for example, my sister's sick, so I have to take care of her. Mm-hmm. And while my mom's working, and I watch my sister help take in the groceries, make my bed, blah, 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 do some chores.
Lots of ways you help out. Wow.
Oh,
thank you. Okay, and Lila, what did you want to share?
I help my mom and my parents fold their clothes.
Fold the laundry. That's a big help, too. All right, thank you. So I'm going to take the giraffe while we stand up and take our exercise stretch. And you would like to lead us? Okay. So stand up, please, carefully. And Monet will lead our exercise.
Okay. So, do you want to do it this way first?
Sure. Okay. You lead us.
Exercise your body, exercise your mind. Learn about the world around in exercise kind.
This way.
Exercise your body, exercise your mind. Learn about the world around in exercise kind.
And this other way.
Exercise your body, exercise your mind, and learn about the world around in exercise kind.
All right, thank you, Monet. Excellent, excellent. So Monet, well, you can hold this now because I want to open the mystery box for our story. You're curious about the last question, but we need to keep moving. So I'm going to open this because today's story is close to my heart, and pretty soon you'll know why. This is a true story, and it's about two of the children that are in this picture. I'm not going to tell you which two, but if you listen carefully, you will learn about them.
Do you know
these children? Do you know them? If you don't recognize their faces, I'll have to say you decide. I don't know if you know them or not. Okay, so I'm going to tell you a true and terrible and wonderful story. Now, every time that I say, "Did George give up?" you're all going to answer, "No, he didn't." So let's practice. Did George give up?
No, he didn't.
Okay. So once upon a time, there was a little boy named George. He was my big brother. The boy grew up, and his grown-up job was to listen to children, troubled children, children who were hurting in their hearts or minds. When Dr. George listened to their troubles, he searched his heart and mind for how he could help them to get better. His job was a child psychiatrist. He always wanted to help. And this is a picture of George as a grown-up. That's my brother. That is my brother, yes.
Is he still living?
He is. So, did George give up?
No, he didn't.
One day, 18 years ago, as he did his job at the hospital, Dr. George met and listened to a new little girl. She was 7 years old. The girl had been placed in the hospital because she had no one to take care of her. This happens sometimes, and it happened to her. Her hair was dirty, and all she owned fit in a small plastic grocery bag. Her paperwork said she was unmanageable and unadoptable. Do you know what that means? Yes?
No one wanted to adopt her.
No one wanted to adopt her because she was kind of wild and out of control.
But I'm betting the parents.
Okay, I'm going to keep going so we can keep going. Did George give up?
No, he didn't.
Dr. George looked at this little girl and he said, there has to be a home for her. In his heart of hearts, George believed that every child belongs in a family and that there must be a way. Did George give up?
No, he didn't.
So, Dr. George picked up the phone and called the Department of Health and Human Services. I need a family for this girl, now, to help her through treatment and then to adopt her. But there wasn't any family through that department. Did George give up?
No, he didn't.
George and his wife, Carolyn, were part of a church, so George called them next. This was George's community. Someone else may have called on their Jewish, Muslim, Rastafarian, or Native American, or whatever community that they are close to that takes care of the young and the weak. Who will take this child, he asked. But taking a child you've never met before is a very big commitment, and there was not even a church family who felt ready to do that. Did George give up?
No, he didn't.
George went back to listen to the little girl, but he knew that sometimes you can get to know someone in other ways than just talking. So he asked her to draw a picture. Draw me a picture of what makes you happy. She drew a picture of herself going to church. Oh, when did you go to church? George asked. She told him she had never been to church, but had heard about church when she went to camp, especially for kids who had had a hard life like hers. Did George give up?
No, he didn't.
I'll see what I can do. And because it was such a simple request, George was able to find a family who was happy to pick her up on Sundays and take her to church. Every week they were happy to take her, and so she joined the Sunday school and joined the children's choir. Did George give up?
No, he didn't.
So, meanwhile, she lived at the hospital for many months. One day, she got a big surprise. Her brother, who she hadn't seen in a long time, was brought to the same hospital. He, too, had nowhere to live and was described as unadoptable. Did George give up?
No, he didn't.
George was able to get permission to take the brother to church, too. By going to church, both children were practicing getting along with lots of different people. And people were getting to know them and care about them and want them around. They took these kids to swimming lessons and sports teams. Did George give up?
No, he didn't.
Now, Dr. George was thinking it was time for the children to think about being adopted. But the little girl said, no, forever families are scary. I want a family where I can practice and learn how to be part of a real family. Did George give up?
No, he didn't.
Dr. George listened to her idea. Again, he went to the church, which by now really knew the children, and asked, would anybody like to be a practice family for them? They don't want to be adopted yet. That is too frightening to be assigned forever, but they do want to practice. And the wide church family can be their extended family of aunts and uncles and grandparents. Did George give up?
No, he didn't.
There was a family. In December, 6 months after George first met her, the brother and sister moved into the practice family. And by August, 8 months after practicing, they all decided they were ready to adopt each other. And that was not the end of the story. George and his wife, Carolyn, had found a real medicine for real kids. Love in families who had love enough to share. And so now they started an organization called Hope and Home, and they have helped over 200 children find homes in loving families. And so this is a story of hope. Did George give up?
No, he didn't.
What was the kid's name?
So here are the kids? Again, you're guessing, and I'm not going to tell you because I'm going to respect her privacy. But it's a true story, and I wanted you to know it. So I'm going to officially name our new giraffe Dr. George, because Dr. George asks lots of questions. He's curious. He asks questions. He listens to their answers, and he tries to help. And so I think that's a great mascot for the Curious Giraffe Show. Would you please turn the page to the next song, and we'll finish with Home is Where the Heart Is, which you learned last time. Would anyone else like to hold this, or shall this? Okay, you hold it and help the giraffe to sing with us, okay? Here we go. Ready?
Home is where the heart is, where I lay.
Thank you for joining us for the Curious Giraffe Show for curious kids of all ages. We'll see you next time. Bye.